So give us a sense, put this in perspective. The president spoke out both on currency manipulation and on the Fed yesterday. How seriously should we take this? And I'll put as a backdrop of this what the Atlanta Fed is showing as far as GDP growth goes here. We'll put that up from my terminal to show the economy is still growing pretty nicely.
Yes, the U.S. economy is doing quite well. We entered the third quarter with a lot of momentum. PMIs holding up, retail sales obviously surprised on the upside. We saw some very good numbers from some of the retailers who reported. So the U.S. economy in the third quarter is probably going to do fine.
So if that's right, why would the Fed back off of raising rates?
They absolutely will not.
Oh.
So, look, the president is going to continue to engage in his usual rhetoric. I think much of it is probably aimed at the current negotiations going on in Washington. I think simultaneously we're going to see a meeting between U.S. officials and Chinese officials in the next couple of days, as well as with Mexico in the next couple of days. So that's all rhetoric. At Morgan Stanley, we've been calling for a peak in the U.S. dollar for really the last 3 months. I think we're starting to see that thesis play out. And it really has a lot to do with the fact that the long dollar position in the world had really gotten to a point of extremes, particularly reflected in the futures market. And I think we're starting to see that reverse as the markets recognize that the Fed is probably not going to back off. We're probably at a maximum of growth differentials, economic surprise differentials, inflation differentials around the world. And it's really time to kind of rebalance. And I think as things outside the U.S. Start to catch up where they hadn't in the first half of the year, we're going to see some of those currencies strengthening. So I don't think it's manipulation. I think it's economic growth with Europe and China catching up.